Hello and welcome back to the Journey to Pro, day number 9. We're going to get straight into a game because I'm actually feeling very motivated to play for some reason today. I said yesterday that I wasn't having one of the best days, but for some reason, recently, I've gotten this kick in the backside to just... I feel like I want to play the game nowadays. Like nowadays. Nowadays. As if it's been longer than 24 hours. It literally hasn't been more than 24 hours, but today I feel motivated to play. And motivated in the sense that, like, not in the sense of like, you know, oh, I have this sun drive. It's like, today I've been playing a bit. I've gotten my mechanics up. I've done a bit of Kovacs. Actually, I'm gonna be honest with you guys again. I have not done Kovacs. And I've been looking at people. Ooh, Midas is looking at extra fine today. No, not the full gold version, the non-default. Thank you. Have we got a golden pickaxe to match? Okay, we'll use this one. Yeah. I've been feeling good. In the sense of like, bro, I've been playing better. I've been working on mechanics. I've been finding out new things. And as Ty Lopez would once say, or have said, here in my garage, standing here with my Lamborghini, you know what I like more than material things? Knowledge. You see, I have now gained the knowledge to my mechanics and why certain things were going wrong with my things, with my my building and my fluidity with my gameplay. You see, I would always be very choppy whenever I was going for edits or trying to, you know, maneuver my way in box fights. And it was simply because of the fact that I was chasing too many rabbits at once. And so I wasn't able to do one thing at a time, which was my main issue. So you see, my bind right now is Q for cone, as you can see, and F for edit. And so every time I have my finger on the cone button, I struggle very hard to press F at the same time without like fucking up eternally, right? And so I've just realized now, in order for me to be able to edit very quickly, like have a good edit speed and be consistent, I need to give up the ability to not cone. Like, I can't cone and then instantly edit, you feel me? Otherwise my entire finger setup will get fucked. So I need to edit my cone. I need to go cone, go back to where like I can move left again, which would be A, and then I can start editing. But before I was trying to cone and edit at the same time, which completely threw off my game, and I would have this like jitter moment where I would be stuck in place and I wouldn't be able to move, and I would get angry in game, thinking, you know what, why is this happening to me? Why can I not edit? Or why can I not place a cone and edit at the same time while still being fluid like I normally was before I changed my keybinds, which I haven't changed them very much, but obviously changing them after not playing the game for such a long time really did fuck up my sense of, you know, movement. Now I've realized, oh, I know how to actually play the game now. I know how to edit, I know how to fight, and I've been winning a lot more of my fights in these Unreal ranked lobbies. Now these kids should be shit, and that's why I was actually getting angry, and I am 100 million percent dead here. However, can we pull something out of the fucking... We can pull something out of my ass. Minis? No, this game hates me. Another day, another victory for the OG. Is what I want to be saying after this game. Oh, the kit. There's no chest here. That's perfect, isn't it? We're just going to pop this, otherwise I'm basically guaranteed to die, which is not what we want. Let me quickly... Well, that's one way to go out, I guess. But yeah, a lot of my fights I've been feeling more like even there, I felt like I was able to move. Obviously, I got put into the worst situation because this game doesn't have siphon. So if you get tagged at all from spawn and you have no meds, you're basically fucked. Which is why I kind of hate this game in the sense of like they did this to ranked. But when I used to play, it used to be just the case of you got a kill in a ranked game mode and then you got health from it so you could actually, you know, have a standing chance against someone. Now you can kill three players and you will be completely scuffed, which won't be your fault majority of the time, because what players do now is they wait for people to get into fights, and then they take a lot of damage and then they push, which I don't hate anymore. I was really against it, but then I realized, oh, that's the way of the game, because, well, that's how you win the game, you feel me? Like, logically speaking, why would you go and attack someone in a 1v1 situation when you can wait for these two people to clash, right? Then they take a little bit of damage, either one of them comes out alive, or in the best case scenario, you hear them both get really cracked, you hear them both hit another shot, which basically means they're both one tap, then you jump in, steal both kills, and then that's a free two kills without you having to take much damage at all if you play it smart. And so I can understand why people, you know, just out of nowhere decide, you know, I'm just jumping in your box as soon as I hear someone else come, or they'll just wait behind the corner and then come and push you once you finish the fight. At least if I was someone who actually valued ranked, that's how I would play. And because there's a leaderboard system now, people actually do value ranked, which is baffling to me, because it's been 5 years and these kids have been playing ranked and they haven't made any earnings from the game at all, and they think that's the way, this is the way to show that you're good, which isn't. So as soon as you start getting siphoned again into this game, I think people will actually start enjoying it, because then ranked will actually, you know, feel competitive. I might have to land island. There's another kid landing here, which is not good, to say the least. We pop a shield. Now we're in this situation where there's... So you guys can hear the other kid now. So if I rift here, I'm probably gonna get beamed, but you know what? It's a play I'm willing to make. You have an SMG now. All we need is a medkit and we'll be chilling. Okay. I'm not complaining. Right now I have 75 mats, so I'm probably going to die from not having mats, but you know, we should be fine. Thing is, I feel like this kid's going to be watching me from above, or someone else is going to be watching me. And so in this meta, realistically, if you're ever like... if you're trying to play to seriously win in ranked, you really shouldn't be taking fights unless you hear someone else fighting. At least in my opinion, if you care about winning. I think I'm gonna drop minis, Loki. If I could get an AR, that'd be nice. We're not doing too shabby on mats either, which is always pleasant. I think I'm gonna take that instead. Question is that kid still up here, and did someone loot this place? Did someone loot this place first of all? The answer is definitely no. Which is always good. Always good, always good. Look at that, bro. Yeah, I'm gonna drop. Yeah, these purple places on the map are actually insanely good. I think I can take an AK. Actually, I would take an AK if I was holding an SMG. Scar maybe. A GL. I'm gonna be dirty. I don't even care. I can't tell if I just saw a kid or if that was a tree. I'm pretty sure that was a tree, though. Yeah. Fresh grabs. The hell is that? What are these? What does he do? Oh, one of the hand grapplers. That's cool. I actually don't know what this thing is though. If I don't want to fight him because I don't want to shoot him because I feel like he'll kill me. Or he'll start attacking me. I don't know if there are any kids here either. Which is going to be fun to see. Hello, people. I say people like there's going to be more than one kid here. But realistically, only one kid has came out of this place. I swear blue vending machines have nothing now. Yeah, I don't know. I think it's because they took everything out of the game that's like blue. So having blue vending machines is kind of stupid, okay. I don't know why they still have them in. Oh, so someone has been here, so he's probably... He might actually be a... Like, oh, I just realized there was a bush and I didn't top it. 23 people. I wanted to talk about something today. I mean, obviously I wanted to go over the fact that, well, I'm feeling motivated today, which should tell you guys something, that your emotions can really change on how you're playing. Or like, your emotions will always change, right? They'll never be static. You'll never always want to play the game, and you'll never always want to not play the game. I don't even know if that makes sense, but I hope you get what I mean. Like, there will be some days where you just don't want to play, and there are some days where, you know, the only thing you want to do is play. And that's honestly the same with everything, you know? You're not going to want to do the same thing every single day. And so it's never about whether you want to do something or not. Don't tell me this kid... No, okay, we're good. I thought that was a bush. That bush looks very different to that one, though, which is weird. It is what it is. Yeah, you're not always gonna wanna play the game every single day, which is completely reasonable. You don't need to want to do something to do it. You feel me? I don't always wanna play this game, although it's fun. And I don't always wanna work on my aim and shit. Although, playing this game is actually really fun. Dumbass. Get out of my fucking game. Holy. Jarvie. But yeah, sometimes you're not always going to want to play this game, which is completely reasonable. And sometimes you're not always going to want to practice your aim. And sometimes you're not always going to... You're not always going to want to, you know, play scrims, which are very much necessary to, like, improving. I mean, depending who you are, you get me? I mean, scrims, you can never get worse by playing scrims. Hello? Please don't tell me I died to fall damage from that. I've just disconnected from the internet. Oh lord, that... If I said I was gonna get angry, it would have been an understatement. Don't know why I'm getting this much packet loss though. There it is, there's the loot. The thing is now, I reckon I actually want to pump. Let me keep this pump. And do I take bigs or minis? Fuck it, we take minis. We risk it. Risk it for a biscuit. And so yeah, I'm still gonna be playing these games on the days I don't feel like it, just like you saw yesterday. Although I didn't play good, I still played because I know that... Oh, is that Chug? should probably pop a medkit as well, no? Did we have a medkit? I swear we had a medkit, yeah. Because I know for a fact, in the long run, these little days where I'm not feeling the greatest, but I'm still out here playing, it's going to contribute to whether or not I actually improve. You feel me? Yeah, it's going to contribute to whether or not I improve in the long run or not. Which, in a series called The Journey to Pro, I'm pretty sure you know what my goals are. I'm trying to improve. I'm trying to become a professional player. Not on some shit where it's just like, bro, I actually can't stand them. You know those videos where it's like, oh, guys, I'm becoming a pro. And then they've gotten like 150 PR and nobody actually knows them because they're not real professional players. The standard of professional player I'm talking about when I'm making these videos, by the way, is like, maybe not as good as them, but on par with like the Noah Riley's, the Tatons, the them lot. That's what I'm doing this series to become. This isn't some like pussy shit where it's just like, oh guys, I earned $100 from a Fortnite cash cow. No, this is not even remotely the same thing. Not even close. This is like, I'm trying to be better than literally everyone in the, not everyone, but I mean, I'm trying to be better than everyone, but I'm not. We'll see how far I get, okay? I don't wanna jinx myself or say nothing's not possible, because I mean there's no real difference between me and Noah Riley besides, I don't know, how long we've been playing and two, how good our skills are and how good we are at the game, which is something that I can improve. You feel me? Obviously he's got better specs and shit like that, but right now I can definitely improve. I can improve that, just not right now. I don't know why I'm using Noah Riley. Apparently he's washed from what I've heard, but like, I'm trying to become a T1 player, like an actual T1 player. This isn't, I hope you get what I'm trying to say here, because these people online where they're like, oh, I'm trying to become pro, and then they still do Mongrel Classics on people looking directly at them, like the most brain dead people in the world. That's not becoming a pro. Why am I getting fucking packet loss, bro? I hate this game. I actually hate it. I see one Mongrel move. Like, bro, it's actually so bad. Bro, I've just disconnected. I fully disconnect. Question is, where are these last players and why are they not coming out? Like, I'm gonna get into a fight with the... Like, bro. Don't tell me I died. Tell me it's the whole servers and it's not just me. Hello? Game? Thank you? Like, holy shit. Bro, is the kid who's running the server booting everyone off? What the fuck is going on? Oh, you're dead. Do you have a scar? No, but you have a gold GL. Fucking hell, lad. I can't even fight people. Fucking dumbass, bro. Heal. Motherfucker has a little campfire. Like there, right there, I would have already been 150. I'm pretty sure, right? If I do the math. I would have been 150 already, but without Siphon, this game's terrible. Donnie had a fucking spaz on the scar. Okay. He's on the hill, isn't he? Motherfuckers gatekeeping in Storm. See, and so now if I push someone, I will get third party just like that kid tried to do to me, you feel me? Like, I got fully beamed. And so to play in these games, it's not intense or anything. That's how you know it's not intense. Fuck me. Wrong play, bud. Wrong play, bud. Wrong fucking play. question is, where are the last four players? I kid you not, I'm actually not scared at all, because I can tell that these kids are all going to be drones. One kid. Boom. Definitely baited out. Okay, I lied. It's not baited out. He's got the high ground, boys. He's got the fucking high ground. Unlucky Eternal, bro. Fucking useless. Wait. No way, I have Storm. Oh my god, I can be a waiter. Oh my god, I'm being a waiter. This is it, chat. This is it. No way. Last kid. Oh, finally. I know, boys, never thought you would have seen the day from me getting a win in rank on a video. This is beautiful. This is gameplay. This is actual gameplay. Boys, we've hit 88k on it. This is so sexy. But yeah, you guys saw what I meant by that, innit? Like, you can't fight anyone without there being a third party. Even then, while I was fighting kids, I was getting beamed left and right. So I had to play that endgame as if it was a fucking cash cow. But yeah, you guys get what I mean. And so I hope I went over the topic of not feeling like playing the game well with you guys. And to make sure to implement that into your gameplay if you're trying to genuinely get better. Because that's what I'm doing for myself. I don't always feel like playing this game. And so sometimes I play the game without feeling like it, simply for the simple factor of knowing that it will help me improve. Sometimes you have to do the things that you don't want to do. That might be improving your builds, improving your aim, improving your game sense, improving anything, improving your comms, just in order to reap the rewards, which will be, you know, being able to, one, place, and to become an actual pro who earns money. You can look at all these other bullshit YouTubers who are telling you, oh, the way to become pro is to ensure that you guys play the game, enjoy it while you play. But the funny thing is, although the players at the top do enjoy the game, right? They do enjoy it. I still enjoy the game. There are periods where you don't feel like playing and you'd rather watch YouTube, you'd rather watch TikTok, eat food, chill out. And at those times where the players at the top know that that's what they want to do, they still hop on the game and play to improve. And that is what separates the average player from the T1s, playing the game whether or not they feel like it. And so yeah, I hope that win was fun for you guys as much as it was for me. I mean, Unreal or rank doesn't really count as anything, does it? But you know, we've also improved our finger mobility, so I'm starting to actually get better at the game, which is always nice to see. And again, that's from playing the game when I didn't feel like it, learning the things that I needed to in order to get better. So yeah, hope you took a lot away from this video. I'll see you guys in tomorrow's episodes. Might actually record another episode for you guys, I don't know. Let me know, what would you guys rather have, 2 episodes in one day or 1 episode every single day as like a journey series? So we can always have like the journey episode and then another episode where it's just like we can just do whatever, like we can talk, I can show you guys more of what I'm doing, etc. Or would you guys rather me stream or something along those lines? Let me guys know in the comment section down below. Anyway, take care. Bye.